Hello friends, welcome to the NIOS studio. I am Sarika Rai Sharma, Assistant Professor, Mahatma Gandhi Antarashtriya Hindi Vishwavidyalaya, Wardha, Maharashtra. Today, in this particular video, we will discuss the concept of waiting children. The first question that comes to our mind is, who are these waiting children? So, this term is used to identify a child usually in the foster care system who is waiting for adoption. These children generally are of a school age, members of a sibling group, children of color, and have physical, cognitive, and emotional problems that may be the result of experiencing abuse, abandonment, and neglect. These are the children who are waiting to be adopted, that is, children who are legally free for adoption. They are in the care of the public child welfare system and cannot return to their birth homes and hence need permanent families. So, what are the characteristics or features of these children? So, we can say that the waiting children generally refers to non-infant, school-age children who have become legally available for adoption. They will generally be under the legal jurisdiction and care of public foster care agencies. Many waiting children will have siblings who are also available for adoption and who would prefer to stay together as a family unit. Also, in most geographical locations, more than half of the waiting children will be ethnically diverse or will be children of color. Here, children of color refers to the racial diversity. They will have come into the foster care system for a variety of reasons, which could include neglect, abandonment, abuse, and or some other dysfunction within their family environment. As a result of this, they may have physical, cognitive, emotional, and behavioral problems, thus making them challenging for the caregivers. However, with affection and proper care, their problems can be addressed. Two things that all waiting children usually have in common are, first, their need to become a permanent part of a responsible and nurturing family, where they will get unconditional love and encouragement to achieve their full potential. And secondly, they can bring tremendous joy and satisfaction for their new families. Regarding what is the adoption system for such children? According to the Indian adoption system, except for adoption by Hindus, Indian law has no provision for adoption. Children are placed under the guardianship of adopting parents to exit the country, and adoption must take place in the parents' home country. Given that the life of a child in foster care system is often filled with separation and loss, it is not surprising that behavioral and emotional issues are very common in these children, which, if not attended to properly and in time, may render them as children with special needs. So, what are the common diagnoses of waiting children in foster care? How will you identify such children? So, the very first symptom that these children show is anxiety. It is characterized by excessive and exaggerated worry about everyday life events, with no obvious reasons. People with symptoms of anxiety tend to always expect disaster and can't stop worrying. Daily life becomes a constant state of worry and fear to them. Eventually, the anxiety so dominates the person's thinking that it interferes with daily functioning. Secondly, such children shows symptoms of asthma. Asthma is an inflammatory disorder of the respiratory tract that causes attacks of wheezing, shortness of breath, chest tightness, and coughing. Also, such children exhibit polydipsia, that is compulsive water drinking. It is a medical symptom in which the patient displays excessive thirst. They also show depression. Now, depression is a serious medical illness. It's more than just a feeling of being down in the dumps for a few days. The feeling just don't go away. They persist for a prolonged period and interfere with the everyday life of the waiting children. The symptoms of depression can include sadness, being easily annoyed or feeling irritated, loss of interest or pleasure in activities that they used to enjoy, change in weight, difficulty in sleeping or oversleeping, feelings of worthlessness, thoughts of self-injury, death or suicide. Such children also show developmental delay. Delay can occur in one or many areas, such as gross or fine motor, language, social or thinking skills. They also show anuresis. Anuresis or bedwetting is involuntary urination in children over 5 to 6 years old. It may occur at any time of the day or night. They also show encopresis. Encopresis is the voluntary or involuntary passes of stools in a child who has been toilet trained, typically over the age of 4 years, which causes the soiling of clothes. Encopresis is frequently associated with constipation and fecal impaction. Other causes may be related to a lack of toilet training or being toilet trained at a very early age. Emotional disturbance such as oppositional defiant disorder, where the person starts questioning the authority and they don't want to obey their orders. They also show hyperphagia. Now, hyperphagia is associated with excessive hunger and an abnormally strong desire or need to eat. This can be related to an underlying medical or psychological condition. Such children also show conduct disorder. The child may develop shame, guilt, or loss of self-esteem because of the very fact that the child is not being adopted by anyone. They take it as if there is something wrong with them. So they suffer from a feeling of shame or guilt and low self-esteem. Sleep disorders. Sleep disorders involve any difficulties related to sleeping, including difficulty falling or staying asleep, falling asleep at inappropriate times, excessive total sleep time, or abnormal behaviors associated with sleep. Such children also show learning disabilities. Many waiting children may face difficulties in comprehending, processing, or retaining oral and/or written information. The most common problems are attention deficit disorder, hyperactivity, and dyslexia. Emotional difficulties. Emotional difficulties can also result in a child having behavioral difficulties like holding food, withdrawing, having difficulty telling the truth, and competing for attention are among the most common behaviors shown by waiting children in foster care system. If a child is unwilling or unable to discuss these experiences, the frustration may be so overwhelming that it affects the child's ability to function on a day-to-day basis. Reactive attachment disorder. The reactive attachment disorder is a rare but serious condition in which the waiting children don't establish healthy bonds with caregivers. A child with reactive attachment disorder is typically neglected, abused, or moved multiple times from one caregiver to another. Since the child's basic needs for comfort, affection, and nurturing are not met, he or she never establishes loving and caring attachments with others. This may permanently alter the child's growing brain and hurt their ability to establish future relationships. So, in this particular presentation, we discussed the concept of waiting children and the impact of stress among children who are waiting for adoption in foster care. Also, we discussed early trauma and stress can have a lasting effect on development, triggering delays in social competence and development of dysfunctional coping behaviors among such children, particularly when the adverse condition is chronic and there is a lack of nurturing support. In such situations, counseling and other therapeutic services are used to address the problems of the waiting children. In particular, such issues can only be resolved through loving, stable relationships, such as can be offered by nurturing caregivers who can provide the waiting children with a sense of safety, healing relationships, and effective self-management and coping strategies. Here are a few URLs that you can visit for helping children who are waiting children. Thank you.